I just videotaped this whole section. It's so annoying with this. I gotta get some better equipment. Anyway, here we go again. This is my other 2003. I just showed you guys how to pop this thing off. It's got little slots here that these things pop into. You gotta just kind of reach underneath the lip and pop it off. Before I go on, I'll do the other side so you can see it. Hopefully this stays on. There's five giant bolts you gotta take off. One's there, two of them are over there, you can see them. Then there's two more over here. And then you gotta take these two little guys off right here. No big deal, take those off. And this entire assembly pops off. Literally comes right off. And you can move it to the back over here. And then you have complete access. You can pull the carpets back. You don't have to cut them. And then I'm going to cut this one a little tighter than I did my other car because I used 7x11. I think I'm going to do about 6.5 by about 9 inches because that's all the space you really need to work it underneath there. Why cut a giant hole? So let me go to the other side here real quick. And I just want you to see how easy it is to pop this out. So you drop this down and you're like, oh, hey, what do I do here? You pop it out. Grab one end like this and just... not like that. I can't get it off. All right, let me try it again here. Hold on. Let me try this side, I guess. I don't know. Weird. Oh, wow. All right. Oh, here we go. Wow, I cannot get this off. Wow, okay. Oh, my goodness. It should come off. Anyway, it usually pops right off. I think I'm going to spray a little... maybe I use two hands. Hold on one second. Hold on one second. I don't know if you can see me from this vantage point, but I'm going to. Maybe I need two. Yeah, so it should just come right off, man. Oh my gosh. There we go. This dog was in there good. All right, so usually it's not that hard, you guys. And when I put them back, I clean all this up, by the way. When I put them back on, like this one is already broken, it looks like. When I put them back on, I'll put some grease on them. So if the fuel pump ever goes out, it won't be like that. That was crazy. This is the third one I've popped out, two in the other vehicle, and two here. This was really crazy hard to get off. Anyway, here's the two big bolts back here, and then one on that side I showed you, and then two in front. And you just lift the whole thing out and just kind of shove it back here. But in between, I'm going to clean a little because that's what I like to do. Clean these nook and crannies while I've got access to them. All right, we'll talk soon. All right, so I just tried to take this one off over here. It broke off because I had it righty-tighty instead of lefty-loosey, so I ripped it off, which is when it comes down to... putting these bolts back on, careful with a machine like this, it'll rip it right off. Anyway, this comes off, boom, just like that. See that? Just comes right off. And you should have two bolts, but unfortunately now I only have one holding it down. Same thing happened to the other one, you'd think I'd learn. Anyway, now I'm going to switch. Hang loose. From the 13mm to... the 18mm and connect the take out 5 bolts basically. This one has the seatbelt connected to it. No big deal, no mystery. It's really easy. See how quickly that thing came off with my beautiful Milwaukee. Anyway, this comes off too and it'll come out with the seat. And then you come on over here. Oh god, I can't believe I just did it again. Anyway, slow down. You're moving too fast. Got to... Alright, so here's what... Whoops. Whoops. Okay, the other two you can get at. Put the seat down. Put these guys over here. And the other two are right back here. And that's why you gotta take those back panels off. You can't get to them. So... it's loose. Totally loose. Come on out of there. Alright, so I'm going to put these over here. One big bolt over there for that side and a little one. Two little ones, but I broke the one off. Four bolts over here. Okay, so now it's time to lift this dog out of here. So what I do is I set this back and I put this back. Oops, lights. Oh, don't crush this thing. Excuse me. Put this back down. All right. And then I'm just going to go inside and kind of lift it straight up. You're going to, you know, grab it by that side, lift it up, and then just push it back over there, and you can start working on cutting a hole here pretty quick. So I'm going to put this down for a minute because I don't have a film crew. So I'll be back. Alrighty, so it's off, you see? So you can see the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 big bolts. Two little ones over here. Just do not over-tighten, it'll break right off. Do not use the tool to tighten it up. You can take it off with the tool, but boy, you don't want to use the, what do you call that, tool? Terrible. Anyway, I can't remember. Hey, so I'm going to vacuum a little bit more here, get some of this junk out of here, just kind of clean it up. And then I'll show you what we do next, okay? All right, just vacuumed in here. It's never been vacuumed, but actually, it could certainly use a... this is different, isn't it? Is it different? Oh no. See, this is different. Oh my goodness, see? It's unbelievable. Same year, you guys, as my other one. Yet this one, oh, there it is. Okay, golly, I thought it was one piece. All right, so all you do is, I just yank it out. I kind of pull it out like that. And, yeah, it'll pop off by itself. You heard it pop off, right? And so, I'm going to put this down for a second. Hang on. Hopefully you can see that. Anyway, so maybe you should pop this off a little bit and help it. Hamburger helper, you know. Oh, come on. Actually, yeah, I have to get it up a little higher. All right. Come on now. Get out of there. My other truck came out fairly simple. But this guy doesn't want to. Maybe I need to. There we go. Right, so that's good enough for me. Yeah, that's good enough for me. So kind of bend it. And then what I did is I put something heavy on top of it. But I am going to have to cut right through here. Starting right about here. And then stop right about at the edge of this. So definitely need to be able to move this. Come on now. Man, this one's well made. There it goes. Okay, just kind of pull it out. There you go. So, all right. So I got to put something heavy on this. And essentially you do the other side the same way. You pull this and put something heavy on there, and then it's ready to go. So I'm going to put you on hold for a second, guys. I'll be back. Alrighty, so I kind of vacuumed. This popped up by itself as I was trying to pull this back. You could just pop it back in afterwards. I vacuumed in and around here. Now this is going to make a mess when I cut this. I don't have my new fuel pump yet, so all I'm going to do today is cut this and clean it up inside there. I'm not going to take off the old fuel pump. I don't want gas fumes going through the car. So for now, I'm just going to cut it. Now, just a couple of things. Last time I cut my other truck, I cut along right on the edge of this, and I went out 11 inch, well, right here, right next to these rivets. I didn't want to cut through the rivets, so I just a little over this way, and I ran it right along this, and I went out about 11 inches. Then I came back to about these rivets here. Now, notice that these rivets are kind of circular, right? I just went up to this rivet, because it's the closest one in, and I stopped. And same thing here, I started here and worked my way over here, and I stopped about right there, and then I lifted it up. Now, I did notice that I have lots of room over here, because the fuel pump's over here, right about, I don't know, right about here, roughly. And, you know, you're going to pull it out like this, you have to, because the float is you can't go straight out. The float gets in the way. So it's right here. And what I realized is I don't really need to be right along here. So I'm gonna cut right about here. And I'm gonna run out, and I don't need to be 11 inches this way. It's gonna be more like 10, maybe even 9. I'm a little hesitant to do 9, but 10 is plenty. And so I'm gonna start here, work my over there. Don't cut along here. I'm not cutting along here. This is where my flap goes up. So I'm gonna cut here, here, and here. I'm gonna tape this out now, and I'll be back, and I'll show you the measurements too. Okay? Notice the edge. Notice this bolt, so you kind of get your idea in your head what's going on. And look at all these rivets. People were drilling out rivets and stuff. I'm like, no, thank you. I don't want to do that. I'm gonna cut. It's perfect cut. It's right up to there from about right here. I think it's about 6.5 inches, but I'll figure it out. And then about 9 or 10, about 10 inches here. I mean, I think that's even too long, but I'm almost thinking just do 9 inches over here. And just, you'll have this little spot, you'll be able to reach everything. But anyway, so let's go a little out of time here. Let me tape this up and I'll be back. All right, so here's the mechanism that I'm going to use to cut it. And remember, you don't want to cut too deep into this. You can easily cut through the gas lines, and that would not be a good day for you. So you got to be careful as you're cutting. Only like a half an inch down max, from what I've a little more. I just try not to cut very deep, just kind of grind away, especially on the left side. The left side is where the gas lines are. So this side here is where the gas lines are, right about here. You gotta be careful. So you want to just like, very nimble along here. So you cut along here, cut along here, and cut along here. The tape is inside of the rivets. That's what I did. Nothing along here because you're going to bend it up so you have access, right? So you cut along. Anyway, so let's take a look. So remember, when you're cutting, and by the way, if you smell gas, you are not to cut this because the sparks from that. Anyway, so instead of 7 inches, I've got 6.5 here. Okay, and then I've got 10 inches here, roughly, about 10 inches. Doesn't have to be exact, it's close enough. And the starting point of all the measurements, again, is this rivet line, and then about halfway between the first two ridges, you can see it, right in here. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this, and then show you the insides. I have how many miles do I have? Something like 205 or 210,000 miles on this. Notice I used that to, you know, hold the carpets down. And I don't cut carpets. That's why I took this beast off, because I don't want to cut the carpet. I want it laying back down nice and healthy. So this is really scary. I'm like, every time, the last time I did this, I was just like, I had to like, it's scary cutting this hole. But I'm going to do it, and I'll show you how easy it is. It's not that bad. Unfortunately, I don't have a camera crew. It'd be really cool to see me blow up, right? Let's see. Oh, look at that. Don't fall. That might work, you guys. Alright, okay. So if you see flames, that means I'm having a bad day. Alright, let me go hook this all up. Oh my gosh. Are you crazy, Tom? Yes, I did it once. We could do it again. I did it once. We could do it again. Keep talking to myself. No big deal. Just don't cut the fuel line. That would be bad. Oh, hey. Another thing, too, is I forgot to bring this out because super important. Always have your fire extinguisher ready to go, just in case you do have a bad day. Yeah, you know, one thing is to burn the car down, but to burn the house down, it'll be bad. We'll be right back. I'll be back. Don't be afraid. All right, so I got my fire extinguisher over here, see, and I took the pin out too, so I can grab it real quick and, you know, nail this thing down if bad things happen. Oh, incidentally, I just want you to know, don't do this on your, you know, I get a mechanic to drop the tank and call it a day. I do this because I can, I know I can, I've done it once before, and I'm taking a risk. I do not ever want you to do what I do. Just say that much. So here goes, guys. I'm gonna chop this thing up. Okay. Oh no, it's broken. Oh, come on. There it goes. All right. You know what I need to do? I need to get my protective glasses on. I'll be right back. All right, here we go again. Here we go. Let's see if this. There we go. This side is over. That's it. How long did that take? About 1 minute, maybe two. I don't know. I think I got them all. Let's see. Except I missed right here. Let me see here. Yeah. Right here and right. Okay, right. Okay. Oops, a little bit right here too. I got a few cuts to make. Hang on. Hang on. I didn't quite get it all. Happened last time too. Stand by, I'm gonna go get my pry bar. Let's see how we did. Whew, okay. Yeah, I'm taping. Is it what? No, I'm right in the middle of it, so I gotta keep going. Alright, so I take this and. Yeah, it's all cut beautiful. Beautiful. I just have to pop this out somehow. There we go. Careful here because, boy, that angle grinder really. All right, thanks for staying with me all this time. There she goes. Easy peasy. That does work, actually. I could have probably did 9 inches. See that? I could have done it instead of 10. I had 11 in my old car. Now I'm putting 9, but. Anyway, 6.5. This comes out, believe it or not, it comes out. And so right now I could do no more. I'm just going to clean this up, vacuum in there, make sure it's nice, and we don't want anything falling in. My initial goal was to, remember, about halfway between here, right up to the rivets, and 6.5 inches that way, I would just do 9 inches, really. That's all you need. And just be careful. I was wrong. You got a long way to go to cut into the fuel lines. Just, I remember being closer, but, you know, you do have lots of room. But, you know, just be careful. Just, you don't need to dig in, you know. I would just, you know, half an inch into it all the way around, you're fine. So, that's it. That's easy access, and believe me, it's super easy to replace, too, unless you're in the East Coast, and then it's a rusted mess. And you're going to have to get a new ring. This ring, just order it. If you're in the East Coast, and you got rust under your car, just order that ring along with it. Otherwise, the other thing you might want to order, which I didn't, but these connectors here don't usually come with the fuel pump that you're going to get. So you got to take these off of this old fuel pump and put it on the new one. So I'll be back. So look at this. You know what? Almost. Yeah, 9 inches. So 6.5 by 9 is more than enough space. I'll do this. I'll continue this video as soon as I get my new water pump. Yeah, that's it. Thanks, guys. All right, so I vacuumed a bit in here. I got most of the junk out of there. But when you use the angle grinder over here, by the way, if there's any gas, you smell any gas out of your car, do not use anything that puts out a spark. You can't cut it, basically. Everything's going to put out a spark. You'll have to go and pull, you know, drop the tank. There's no other way. You don't want to have a big problem here. So here's what I'm going to do. The edges and the angle grinder really makes a mess on these edges. So I'm going to clean this up with a wire brush. Then I'm going to show you something here when we get there anyway, but I'm going to show it to you soon. So this is the tab that holds this in place. What you want to do is pull this back, and I use like a washer. Yeah. So it's hard to do it two hands, but you can see what I'm talking about here. Okay, I'm about to lock it in place. Now look where it's at now, and then wait for me. Wait for me. Wait for me. We might have a long wait, my friends. All right. Not that long away. Now look at it, see? I pushed it out and I put the washer in place, so when you turn the bracket, the ring there to unlock the fuel pump, it will slide over. And then don't forget to take the washer out. Okay, so I'm gonna clean this up. And then I'm done. I'm vacuum again. Vacuum should be next to you the whole time. Your fire extinguisher should be next to you the whole time. And you just keep vacuuming, because there's a lot of metal particles all over the place here. So you want to clean that up, especially after I do this wire brush to clean up these edges. There's going to be a lot. And so, talk to you when I get my new fuel pump in the email. Thanks. On this vehicle, the sender wasn't sending correctly. And you'll notice here that this thing is loose, man. It's crazy loose. Weird. It wasn't like this on the last one. I'm not sure if that's the sender or not, but that's loose. One of the things I wanted to tell you is, hold on. So, I use this electronic cleaner and just clean these ends off, you know. It's been there for 20 years. What I'm going to do, I use alcohol to clean this part and underneath and over here, because I'm going to put on these rough edges, which I don't want to clean anymore. I mean, I tried to soften them up with a wire brush, and it's just not working. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some T-Rex tape along here. But in order to do that, you really want to make sure you're all clean with alcohol. So I used alcohol and cleaned underneath there. I know, I'm out of control. I do, you know, I'm overdoing it. But so that when I put this down, A, it'll be you know, T-Rex up against T-Rex. Because if you put this down right now, you're gonna see about an eighth or a 16th of an inch gap all the way around. I want to avoid that. Plus, next time I change this out, I want to be able to lift this up and not cut my fingers or somebody else cut their fingers. So anyway, I took these out, cleaned them with CRC electronic cleaner, and so that when we attach it to the new one, what's weird is my old one had the old style. This is the new style. I've owned this car for a long time, man. I've never had the fuel pump changed. I've owned this car from the beginning, 2003. I've never had the fuel pump changed, so that's odd that two 2003 vehicles, one had this connector and one had the square connector. I had to replace it on the other one to this type of connector. So I don't know what's going on here. Pretty strange. Anyway, again, this is a 2003, and where you saw the cuts, it's for a 2003. Again, I've seen different ones, and it didn't look the same as mine, so be careful. All right, I'll be back. I don't know. Anyway, I'm not going to go there. I fixed it. I'm waiting for my new fuel pump, and we'll go from there. That's all I can do. You can see what I did here. I put this here so we don't have any... The other thing is I don't want anything rubbing against here over time and cutting through and stuff. So that's why I put this here. I don't want anything cutting through, you know, rubbing. Although this is going to be sitting back here, you know, highly unlikely. But I'm ready for my fuel pump. As mentioned before, oh man, I just overdo it. I should just put the darn thing in. What happened to it? Okay, there's a penny. By the way, I got these from, this is like an amazing tool. Ready? Woohoo! These are awesome. Get some butane and get this from 901 Torch, it's called. Works great. I got two of them. One in my boat in case I'm freezing and I have to light the seat on fire to stay warm. Anyway, so you take a penny like this or a washer or something. You see where this thing fits in this little slot. You gotta push this out so you can turn this and be able to take the ring off, and then the fuel pump will come back out. Alright, anyway, we'll talk soon. I'm supposed to get this on Monday, I think, but we'll see. I'm ready to go. Easy peasy. Hey guys. Alright, I finally got my new fuel pump in the mail. This is an AC Delco one, and original part and everything else, so I'm excited to put this in. A couple of things you need right now is you need your penny, or a quarter, about a quarter would work, or this washer, because we got to keep that thing open so I can slide this free. Got a little hammer and a screwdriver so I can tap on it, so I can move this thing. Sometimes I'm assuming you could move it by hand at one point or another, but at some point. But first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to move my beautiful brand new fuel pump out of the way. And I'm going to put it, ooh, that's dirty. I don't want to put it on dirty places. All right, let's do this. Grab that. Yeah, it's about 7 o'clock at night or so. And it's Tuesday, day after Martin Luther King Day, so... yesterday there was no USPS. There was nobody actually delivering, so this poor guy just delivered it. I don't know what time it is, but anyway, first thing we do is make sure you got some towels, because you're going to, this whole area is going to be a little bit flooded with gas, and make sure you don't have any sparks. You got some aeration going on, which I didn't do. Let me do that right now. Okay. Open this door and let it aerate, you know. Also, if you smell gas, you got a problem. So you don't want to be banging on stuff like I'm about to do. What I'm going to do is I'm going to bang on this until it turns counterclockwise. As soon as I open this up with that penny, a penny will work, or a washer like this will work to keep it open while you're tapping on this to turn it. So you could cause a spark, right? So if there's anything leaking at the moment, that could be a problem. So just be careful. I, again, do not recommend this at all to anybody. This is me doing it. I trust myself, and also I have a fire extinguisher ready to go. Keep that in mind. All right, so I'm going to put this down for a second. Let's see if I can. Let's see. Can I? There you go. All right, let's see if we can do this. Yeah, look at that. It's going to fall. There it goes. It's falling. Yay. All right, let's see about this. How about this? Does it fall now? Except it's not very... Well, I don't know. There you go. All right, so what I'm going to do is, you can see this. I am going to squeeze both sides. I got to move it a little bit because I cannot reach the bottom one. Still can't, actually. So I don't know which way I'm going to move it. Is it this way? Yeah. So then you just kind of work this out like this. I hope you can see that. Work it out. Work it out. It's almost out, actually. Sorry, guys. Wish I could do better, but can you see that? Let's see here. Wow. Well, anyway, so I'm gonna try it. You saw what I did. You push and it's already loose here. There we go. Gonna help it a little with the screwdriver. Yeah, there it goes. Yep. So, you know, easy. Don't yank on it too much. Just slow. Work it. Work it. Work it. Work it. Work it. Work it. Hopefully the last guys who did this didn't botch it, cause me problems. There we go, it's coming out. Oh my goodness, it's having a hard time coming out though. Almost there. Can you see that? Yeah, you can. Cool. That's good. So, yeah, the screwdriver is a little easier to do. So. There it goes, boom, immediately got gas. See that? Not good, not good. But do the other side too, try it. So one's done. What happened to my, yep, I'm starting to smell gas. Yeah. Okay, well, obviously I had some trouble here. Ooh. It's really hard to film and do this at the same time, you guys. So just bear with me, okay? And there we go. Oh, this is so annoying. I gotta tell you, I don't know what to do about this. How about that? How's this? You see that? Yeah, you can't see that. So you squeeze these little guys and work this out. And sometimes you're gonna need a little screwdriver to help you out. And I mean, just light, right? See, these are already squished down. It's just need to pull this out carefully. I'm just helping it. A hamburger helper with the screwdriver. See how it moved? It moved when I helped. Wow. Why is it so hard? Whew. All right. It's coming out, though. There it goes. There it goes. There it goes. Easy, easy, easy. Can you see me, guys? Yeah, you can. Am I filming? Yep. So. We're past the clips. It's just a matter of pulling out just a hair more. It's a long, long little thing, and these are kind of tough. So, they're not like flexible, right? They're kind of a plastic or something. I don't know. Oh man, woo! Having a hard time with this, guys. Why is this one so hard? Whew. Oh man, come on, baby. It's coming out. Little bit at a time. Man, what the heck? Woo! Wish I can take this out and I can pull it off. And we gotta save these buggers because the new one doesn't have these locking things in there. So, whew, well, that one's, this has been the toughest one. Whew. All right. And another reason I actually taped these off, because you're struggling in here, and man, it is super sharp here after you use the angle grinder. So it's good to have these here, so if you bang your hand in, you're not cutting up your hand. Wow, this is strange as can be. I don't want to break it either, because yeah, that would be really bad, and I'm stuck here. Oh, okay, cool. I'm okay with that. Why doesn't this come out, though? Now, I'm in trouble. Trouble. Toil and bubble. Uh-huh. Well, gotta be careful here, because this is live action for you guys. Not a happy moment right now for me, I gotta tell you. Gotta be careful. I don't wanna destroy this, right? I just wanna pull this out. Wow, be careful. Why isn't this? Wow, crazy, huh? All right, this is different. Wow, I have no idea why it's like this. It is getting better and better. All right, so this is a problem.
Boy, is it a problem.
Okay, so I've got some, I don't know if you can see this, but it's called deep creep. So I'm gonna spray this in here because man, oh man, oh man, this is frightening, let me tell you. Okay. Okay, if I push here too. Strange how this thing just doesn't want to come out. You don't want to break this. This would be really bad if I broke this. There it goes. Oh my god, come on out. I just saw it come out. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Okay, spill some of it out. Beautiful, thank God. Oh my gosh. Look at this. I don't know what's stuck in there so badly. It's this thing is still even. Man. Just hope I didn't do a lot of damage, guys. Hopefully I didn't do a lot of damage. So you gotta take this thing off. Yeah, it wasn't coming out. It's just, I kinda wish I got a new one. Weird, huh? Come on out. Come on. That's it. Just stay there. And then we'll do this side too. There it goes. Alright. Alright. Alright, well. Phew, that really stunk, you guys. I hope I didn't blow it here. Toss this out. Alright. Okay. So, well, we're going to find out if I blew it. Boy, this would be a real, actually, I would need, just need this piece here. How am I going to get that off? So, alright. So at this stage, we're going to assume nothing's wrong. Okay, I'm going to take this off too. So I'm going to take this off. I'm going to put it on the old one, not the new one. Wow. I didn't have this problem with the last one, let me tell you. Okay, so I'm going to squeeze this, and then, well, I should just take this off and do it later, but. There it goes, that one came off. There we go, so we got these two pieces off. Right, look, we'll put them back on the new one. Might spray this a little. Alright, so, we'll see how bad this was. So this stays out. Now we're free. Okay. And what happened to my okay. Well, that was really annoying, frankly. So here, I don't know if you can see this, but I'm gonna put this, push this out with this, and I'm going to slide my washer in there, and so that it's open. Open position. And can you see that? Yes. Now, you can take my hammer. Where's my screwdriver? What did I do with my screwdriver? It was here a minute ago. That's weird. What did I just do with my screwdriver? Oh, here we go. You can see this, right? Okay. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to just go put it right here. And I'm going to, I don't know if you can see this, but put it right on this edge. I'm going to tap it. Tap, 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 tap. And it's loose. See that? That's why you live in California. There's no rust here. And, you can see where it just kind of went past the spot. It's loose. Cool, huh? Now I'm going to take this. See, the last guy who put this on didn't hold on to this as they were, see this loose? And I think this is the sender for the gas gauge. And it's off and on for like years. And so, anyway, I'm going to put mine on a little bit more carefully, hold on to things, and so this one now needs to get past all this, and whoop, there it goes, it's already loose. So what I do with this is I put it on the grinder, not on, on the brush on the grinder, okay, just clean it up. Although this looks pretty darn clean. So I'm not gonna take this off yet, because I'm gonna go clean this up. So for the time being, guys, I'm gonna put you on pause. I'll be back.
Anyway, so I took the gas tank off, or I guess fuel pump off, and then what I'm gonna do is vacuum around here like this. I already did it, but I'm gonna do that before I wipe it. Whoever put this on last was an animal, I think, probably. Mm. All right, so I cleaned up most I could, and then what I'm gonna do is, as I'm doing, as the vacuum is running, I'm gonna run my cloth through here and wipe it even more. Careful, you know? Careful, because there's like grime buildup right here. And I wanna put my vacuum right where I'm rubbing along. Okay? Okay. So I can get anything that's possibly gonna get into the gas tank. Just careful, you know? I don't know, most people don't do this, but I'm gonna do it. There you go, nice and clean. And I'm just gonna wipe off other places here too. Yeah, very nice and clean. Alright, and remember the washer you used to lock this in place? Remember the washer you used to lock this in place? Make sure you don't drop that in here. Okay? So, we're now ready to put in the new... Alright, so it's all cleaned up. Actually, it's not complete, but I'll do that later. But it's all cleaned up. I'm going to put in a new fuel pump in here. And then... So, look, I'm going to... grab this. I have plenty of paper towels ready to go. These blue shop towels from Costco. They're really cheap at Costco. Excuse me. And I'm ready to go. Whoever put this in last should be... What is this? How do you cut into this? Man. What do I do with that? Right, I'm going to leave that there. Pretend I didn't see it. This is also the same. Crazy. That's so annoying. You know. Alright, well, hopefully it goes on. I'm gonna grab the fuel pump. I'll be back. Is this still running? Alright. Alright, notice on the new fuel pump, I put these things on this one. I took it off the old one. You saw me taking it off. Got it? Take it off the old one. And notice you gotta put this in like this so you don't break anything. And then slowly work your way in. Careful, 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 careful. And of course you put this rubber piece in that came with it. You're gonna notice like, oh, shoot, it doesn't fit. Yeah, it does. You'll see the little slot right here. This little extension will fit in this slot. And then you push it down as you're turning this. So I'm gonna put this on and show you guys. I'm not chicken. I'm annoyed, because where I put this on last was in probably a primate. Okay, so here we go. Here we go. You see that? These little slots, they all line up. And notice this. So now I put that grease on there, and it's going to be, I believe, a lot easier to turn this. Whoa. What the? There we go. All right. So, so I got to push this up somehow. It should turn pretty easy, but I may need to... This was hard on the last one I did. I had to push this one out a ways. Almost needed to put some grease on this as it rotated, you know what I mean? I almost need to put this like that. There it goes. Come on, baby. I should have put my gloves on. That would have been easier. So you crank it clockwise. Okay. I need to go put my gloves on. I'll be back. Excuse me, guys. Anyway, whoever put this on last, so annoying. I could almost... So put these gloves on, because it's kind of sharp. It's hard to grab a hold of. And you push down, and you clockwise it. Very hard. So, one of the things you could do is, you know, I don't know, help yourself, you know? Like this. Nope, still didn't go. Well, let's see here. Where do I click this? Yeah, it's very hard, because I can't... Whoops, there we go. Problem child. All right. You know what I should have done? I don't know. Let's see. No! Okay, somebody say something. I'm gonna hold it down. Push with this here. Come on, man. What is it here? I can't do it. It's not like the other one. Whoever put this on last had those little pieces there. It's just so terribly, terribly poor job. I can scream, you know? Okay. Well, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do, but maybe here. I don't know, guys. It's an experiment right this minute. Wow. This is most annoying. Yeah, he's got that. I'm tempted to. I think it's that piece that I just saw. Let's see if we can get this back out again. Let's just take this out again and consider that chunk. Yeah, see, yeah. Boy, that's a fight. Sure wish I knew which ape did this last. I'm so annoyed right now. See this little piece? I'm gonna have to cut that off. It's the only thing I can do, or maybe. The only thing I think of is this little piece here is causing it not to. Whoop, got a piece of it off already. Okay. Well, I don't know. I don't know, ladies and gentlemen. I really don't know. I wiped everything down, too, you know? Should slide on. Alrighty, well. That hole in that little spot. There it goes. Right. This is rough. I have pushed this down and I cannot turn it. Yeah, I see that. Oh, wait a minute. Is this... Yeah, this should... Yeah, okay. Well, it should work. So, it's a matter of... Huh, boy. Well, you're dealing with what I'm dealing with, so hope you enjoyed this, having fun. My other one had no issues pulling this out. Let me get this out of the way. Let that dry up a little. Got gas on it. I don't know. Boy, this is crazy. I need some sort of tool or gadget to push this down. All right. I don't know. I could tap on it. I just don't want to fire. That would be bad. Nope. It doesn't want to slide on. Why doesn't it want to slide on? Oh man, that ain't gonna work. Whoa. See this side. Comes on. Yeah, so looks like that guy tried to jam this on. Wow, I don't know what's going on here. Okay. I'm not having fun, you guys. It's gonna be one crazy long video. Alright, now what's wrong with this thing? Somebody did that too. Whoa. All right. Wow. You can really dance. Wow, you can really dance. Oh man, this just stinks, you guys. I am beat. It's getting late. Let's see what's wrong. See if I'm doing something wrong. Let's put this in here just for fun. Gotta be this. And then I got this piece here too. What the? Did somebody just jam that? Yeah. How am I supposed to do that? Yeah, I got chunks of stuff down there. Dang it. Whoever put this on last. I am telling you right now. I'm so annoyed right now. I gotta take a razor blade. Whoever did this. Boy. So, what's going on here is somebody really messed up, okay? Like chunks of, I don't know, they were jamming or punching something, or I don't know what the heck, what they were thinking. Now, I guess we gotta get that out of there so the thing doesn't get stuck on that. This one as well. Okay. Okay. Anyone else sticking out? Probably that's what's causing it. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Man, what'd you do? Just kind of jam a screwdriver? What for? Gosh. You know? Yeah, see? What were you thinking? What were you jamming in there? Why were you jamming that in there? Man, oh man. Yeah, hopefully that'll seal. Wow, yeah. Oh my God. Well, I hope you don't have to deal with this. This is what happens when you take it into somebody. Yeah, yeah. We'll have to drop the tank. $1,600, and then they do this. You have the tank down, too. How can you have a problem? You know, it's like... There we go. Oh shoot, did I just drop it in there? Oh, nope, got it right here. Alright. Alright, well, it's not smooth, but at least I got that rough part off, I think. Alright, let's try it again. That's probably the problem. Problem is I got little chunks of little plastic down there. Hopefully it won't be a problem. All right, let's see if we can get this going. That's better. Oh, it's turning now. It already turned. Okay, so what I need to do is grab my gloves. Yeah, was that whatever that animal did? This animal? There we go, it's moving now. Okay, so what we gotta do is just kinda. Oops, I don't want that. Alright. What happened to. Oh my gosh. All right, guys, I'm gonna have to. Sorry, but this has become a giant hassle. I have never thought in a million years that this was gonna happen like this, but here we are. I don't know how to turn it. I almost need to. Ah, man, wow. I got this all the way down. How is this possible?
All right, well, I got it on. I just didn't have this oriented just right, and once I got it into the slot, it turned and it locked over here. You can see the lock over here with the finger, okay? And now I'm gonna slide these on, hopefully. You want it to line up, right? Little slot here is where you want this lined up. And the same goes here. So I'm gonna put this down for a second. I don't know, maybe you can see that, who knows. Yeah, this one was a pain. I thought this was gonna be a cool video, but there it is. That just slides on just like that. Yeah, I'm trying to make sure. Oh, hey, how's it going? And then I slide the other one on too. Bing. All right, now we're gonna, I already did this wiring before, you saw the video. Got it done. Some of this tape got gasoline on it, so it's not as lovely as it was before. Who cares? So I'm gonna go ahead and slide this back in here, and I'm going to, there it goes, boom, just like that, easy peasy. Now hold on to this. Okay, hold on to this as you're pushing it in. There you go. Hold on tight. Don't be shy. Now, let's see if it starts. Oh, man. One thing about this water, this pump, which 192.58971-04. 192.58971-04. Anyway, there you have it for this part of it. I'm going to turn this back on in a bit, okay? I'm going to start this up, and if I don't come back, you know something blew up. Very good. Anyway, started it up. You can hear it running. No noise. Very quiet. My gas gauge works too, which is great. No leaks. Always check, you know, come back here and while it's running, make sure it's not leaking some, you know, gasoline dripping into that little well. So this is all I'm going to do is I'm going to put this tie straps here and here, and I'm just going to bend it down, and I've got this tape called T-Rex. It's super strong tape. I mean, I'm just going to tape off the edges, maybe even a few down the middle, and put the carpet on it and call it a day. If this thing fails, at least I can quick access and redo the whole thing again. Alright, well, thanks for joining me. I may, in fact, show you the taped up end results here once I'm done. That, putting that ring back on was a bear. I don't know. You know, whoever put this other filter on was not an AC Delco Precision, apparently. I don't know. How can you gouge out the sides of this thing? What were you doing? Anyway, I'm so annoyed about that. I had to clean up. You saw me. I had to clean all that up to get the ring on there. Even then, it didn't, you know, turn smoothly, but I was managed to get it done. I had to use the screwdriver and crank on it. So anyway, there you have it. My other one was much easier because it was the original fuel filter or fuel pump, and I was able to take it off and on relatively easy. This one, somebody messed with it. That's why I never send it in, man. All right, well, I started to put T-Rex on. T-Rex is supposedly the strongest stuff in the market. That's this T-Rex. And then we got, of course, Gorilla Tape, which is a little bit more soft. So I started putting T-Rex on, and it wasn't all that great. See, this is not even fully closed. But it's good enough for me. You guys, you decide how you want to handle. Maybe you do want to screw some things in here. I don't know. I don't care. I'm going to have the carpet over the top of this. I got, like I said, those two tie pieces over here. And I'm done. I'm going to have the carpet on top of this. And if I start smelling something, no big deal. Right? I take this off and figure out a different solution. But right now, this is what I'm doing. Again, I don't recommend this, you know. You guys could put some screws in here, a license plate. One guy put a license plate. I said 10 inches here. As you saw, we could probably went 9 inches by 6.5. So I'm done. I'm putting back everything together. And I'm going to call it completed. Hopefully I'm not on the San Mateo Bridge and then it dies on you. You know what I mean? That would be bad. All right. Anyway, thanks for watching. Have a good one. We'll talk soon.